What's up, guys? Welcome back. Glad you're here. On today's episode, we're going to be taking a blast from the past. That's right, and bringing it back, if that makes any sense. What deck is it we're going to be looking at? That's right, we're going to be looking at the Blue Ribbon 323 deck. That's right, by Ethan Friday. So, buckle in your seatbelts. We're going there. Let's go. The Blue Ribbon Rosette Back playing cards were originally printed in 1916 and have long since been a prized deck amongst collectors and aficionados. Their distinct Galoki makes for an elegant design that is fitting for today as it was over 100 years ago. The limited edition release was meticulously redrawn and brought back to life by amateur magician and playing card collector Ethan Friday. This deck was on Kickstarter on September 4th, 2018, and was funded within 24 hours of launch. This deck, like I said, was funded after 116 backers came together and pledged $5,700 of an original $2,500 goal. This deck comes in red and blue only, just like it did over 100 years ago. That's right, this is an identical replica, at least as close as it can get. You're going to have that same beautiful kind of olive-colored tuck box there with that blue ribbon with the numbers 323 in the center. You're going to have that white Victorian border go all the way around the deck there along the front. It's going to say Blue Ribbon Playing Cards and some ad copy about Cincinnati, Ohio with the U.S. Playing Card Company, even though these were printed in Kentucky, just to kind of stick with that same nostalgia. The left and right sides of the tuck box are going to have a blue banner, and inside it's going to say Blue Ribbon. The bottom of the tuck box is going to feature a barcode UPC and some ad copy about the United States Playing Card Company. The back design, depending on the deck, is going to show a preview of what the cards look like. Like I said, these came in red and blue. You're going to see the preview of the card there on the back, a little bit of blue ribbon work there kind of over and above that same white border that went around, and it's going to say playing cards underneath. The top of the tuck box, depending once again on which deck you're looking at, you're going to see it's going to say linen finish on both, but as you can see, there's two different tuck seals. So if you have the blue deck, you're going to see it's going to have a blue seal, kind of reminiscent of the old blue seals from the Cincinnati plant. If you have the red deck, you're going to have the red seal. The larger portion of the inner flap of the tuck box is going to feature the blue ribbon logo and some more ad copy. One of the other things that they brought back to kind of feed that same nostalgia, kind of similar to the reprint of the Jerry's Nuggets I just reviewed, is that same kind of red security tear strip that you've seen from all those years ago. The back design of the deck itself is very beautiful and very traditional with that same Victorian look that we all love from kind of the same thing that we saw in the Aristocrat 727 banknotes. You're going to see an exact hand-drawn replica. The only difference between these and the originals from 100 years ago is the fact that the borders changed and he did thin borders rather than large. You're going to have a couple double borders go along the back side there as well, and this design is elegant as it was then. This deck does come printed by the United States Playing Card Company on their crushed premium stock. That's right, it does have a modern cut as well as an air cushion emboss. With this deck, you're going to receive three duplicate and original Jokers. They're going to all have that blue ribbon logo there in the center. It's going to say Blue Ribbon there underneath. It's going to say Joker in the upper left and bottom right corner in that fancy font. The last card you're going to receive extra is this blank face card. The pips and indices in this deck are also your industry standard. Same as the pips and indices and number cards, the court cards haven't changed either, and these are the same USPC courts that we all love. The aces are also your standard until we get over to the prominent ace. That's right, it's going to be the ace of spades. It's going to say blue ribbon there above in the center. It's going to have an enlarged spade pip with a fancy kind of old English R there. It's going to have a minimal ribbon there in a weird design style. It's going to say trademark underneath the swoops. And it's going to have ad copy about the playing card company in Cincinnati, Ohio. That's all I can say about this deck. Join me now for my final thoughts. Alright, so you want to know my final thoughts on this deck? I give it a 5 out of 5. This is a beautiful deck, hands down, an even more beautiful reprint. I mean, you know, it's there. It has everything, you know? The only thing I'm a little down about that I would closely almost give it a 4 is the extras. I never could get behind the 3 Joker thing. That's always upset me. You know, and I get it, there's things you can do with them or whatever, but it's just not for me personally. You know, the new Jerry's Nugget reprints, same thing. The modern feel ones came with 3 Jokers. One was discolored, so you could do almost like a 3 card Monty even if you wanted to with that, but with these ones, they're all the same, they're all identical across the board. Which, like I said, it's not too crazy. But it would have been cool to maybe see a double backer or a double facer or a blue-red double backer or something, you know, something that you can really, really kind of use, you know, and I'm not saying you can't use that, but you get what I'm saying. But like I said, other than that, that elegant traditional look I just absolutely am infatuated with. I wish more decks could kind of follow that theme, right? And it, like I said before, we're already in these different phases. You know, we've seen the tropical, the leaves and the floral kind of designs. We've seen the casino style designs, right? It's time for the traditional, the standard minimal designs that we all love in Magic. That's what I'm ready for. So I really hope that makes kind of a comeback, you know? I want to see more people doing that because that's what us in Magic need. You know, so much so lately, we're seeing a lot of things done as far as card-wise, designs and whatnot are being kind of aimed at the cardistry world. And that's fine and all, but like I said, it's an oversaturation that's kind of starting to happen. And it's been happening for quite a while. And I'm just as guilty for targeting that market because I did the same thing with the Paradigms. But like I said, overall, beautiful deck of cards. I wish I would have bought an extra set because they're that nice. You can still get these right now. Places like Art of Play, I think, are selling them on sale right now for $7 to $10. I think playing card decks, there's a couple other ones. Like I said, I'll link them all down below where you guys can go ahead and check these out because I'm telling you, once you feel these in your hand, that soft, special crush premium stock in your hands that's made specifically for cardists so it's easier on the fingertips, you're gonna just fall in love immediately. I mean, these cards spread like a dream, fan like a dream. It's just amazing. You know, like I said, they're almost identical to that gold seal banknote deck by Aristocrat, that it's scary. So yeah, good job. So that's all I can say about this deck. Like I said, I'll link everything down below. If you guys enjoyed this review, you know what to do. Smash that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you beautiful people on the next one.